Whoa, we're back. I feel like I forgot how to stream. Hey, how's it going? Hey guys. I'm back for 2 days and then I'm gonna be away for a little bit again, so I apologize. But sorry, who are you? Sorry, Mike. I know. Ugh, it's been a while, but oh, Prep Bros, Captain Coffee Club, SP Wolf Tech, Moran, Scoom, Blind Observer, I forget how to read, everyone, welcome, welcome. Who is this? I know. You may notice that I'm using my potato webcam again, for this right now. It'll all make sense in a bit. Because I'm using my good camera to do some Inktober stuff. Dear stream, I'm confused. So yeah, I was a little late because I wanted to sit down and do sketches off of the stream. I really traditionally, like digitally, I don't have any problem sketching on stream, but traditionally it feels a lot more intimidating. Also because I try not to, I've actually drawn all these before and I was just like moving them onto the paper I'm gonna use. So yeah, I didn't want to do it on stream. Welcome back! You don't have a potato head. I didn't say that. Oh, no, I have a potato webcam. I didn't say I had a potato head. That's you. I also can't adjust where this webcam sits as much as my other ones, so that's why instead of, like, just my face, you're getting the microphone, you're getting a whole lot. You're getting a whole lot. As always, as a reminder now, we've got that little jigsaw piece that if you click somewhere around this area on the screen, you'll be able to, like, do stuff with your kittens and request songs. So right now I'm just playing, I decided I wanted to listen to some St. Vincent on Spotify today because I've heard, like, a few of her songs. I really liked them and people have, like, recommended her to me a million times. And, like, maybe I should just listen to some of this music. Doing a thing that I normally do, which is stream. Hamster, hey, how's it going? Stupid autocorrect, no worries. Potato, potato. All right, so my setup is a little clunky. Oh, Zan the Man, hey, how's it going? Oh, I like your little Eevee. Who's that from? A little Ray Wave, that's adorable. Oh, great, awesome. Yeah, so my setup is a little weird. We'll move over there now. This is it. This is my desk. This is what's in front of me. So I've never set myself up like this before. It's kind of weird. Let me know if you guys feel like my camera would be better anywhere else. Or if I end up like with my paper over here for some reason, let me know. Oh, Candyware! Hey, how's it going? Candy, have you been doing stuff on Twitch? Or do you just have your account to walk around and watch streams? Wow, I love Carson Druitt. I know, I feel so much. That's the other reason I wanted to have a webcam. Because I'm like, oh, I'm just like biting Carson style right now. At work? You do have Twitch now. Oh, that's awesome. You guys, Candyware makes these really awesome little like jewelry that are tiny, tiny foods. They're adorable. You should totally, if she's doing that stuff on stream, like you should totally check it out. Nicky Hands! I know. Ugh. Ugh. It's so weird. You guys can see so much of me now. It's so intimate. They're off your body. You inspired me. Oh, awesome. So yeah, I wanted to kind of do these as warm-up pieces. So I've got like 7 or 8 of these that we can go through in ink today. So. Could flip the camera video. Let's us see it upright. Ooh, 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 fun, 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 fun. I can totally do that. I can go here and go here. Oh, wait, how do... Wait. I don't know if I can do that. I must be able to. There must be a way. I'm just going to open up my Logitech camera stuff. Yes, I will totally do that. Let's flip it around. Ooh, maybe I can do it as a filter. Wait. Boop-a-doo. Put on filter. Effect filters, maybe. No, that won't work, but this might. Rotate? Rotate. rotate? Nicked over all. Using OBS, there is a way by adding a filter. Do you know what the filter's called, Prep Bros? Oh, Darkman, hello, thank you. We're just gonna quickly figure this one out. I'm gonna try scaling an aspect ratio. Scale filtering, no. Resolution, no, that's not it. Okay. I do wish to remove it. Let me check, thank you, because I have no idea what it's called. I'm just like looking through all of them right now. It's gotta be in here somewhere, I guess. Oh, let's put my phone somewhere. Just toss that on the bed. You guys don't spy on my texts. It's over. You guys are adorable. Yeah, so I'm gonna be out at New York Comic Con for a little bit. So if you're going to New York Comic Con, awesome, and let me know, and we can like if you want a con commission, one of these, I can totally do it. If it's like in by tomorrow. Oh, we had a sub. Do we have a sub? What the heck? The key. Thank you so much for 4 months. Oh my goodness. Thank you for all that sub hype, guys. Oh, that's awesome. Nicktober. Oh, thank you so much, Key. Oh, it's crazy that we've had subs for 4 months. That's so insane. No, none of these. In fact, it's gotta be in here. Crop pad, maybe? No. Yes. Maybe there's something in, like, transform. Ooh. Rotate 180 degrees. Did it. Nailed it. Okay, we did it. I might put my camera down here, then. And boop. There we go. I know you're all like, you didn't do it. Why are you saying you did? But I did in fact do the thing. Sorry, I just know I'm not wearing socks. I don't want Twitch to see like a little sliver of foot in there and be like, she's a criminal. You know how it is. You found it. I did find it. It was a transform module. It wasn't like one of the filters. That's why I was confused. Foot band. You joke, but that's like how it works. This is already zoomed in quite a bit. Here, let's zoom in a little more, maybe. And get you guys right on that. She's got tape on. Twitch, don't at me. She's tasteful. They're all wearing pasties, at least. If not tape. Oh, Darkman, thank you so much for getting in on that hype, too. I think we have, like, an exclamation point sub-hype command as well. Pasties! Get out of here, Mikesicle. So it's one of those things. Scoomster! Whoa. Also, Scoomy, when did you change your name? What? Scoomster. Thank you guys for all the sub hype. I'll see you later. Leaving for work to try and have fun without me. I know it'll be hard. It will be hard. Thank you for that 4 months of subs. Are we getting sub noises by chance? Because I'm not hearing them. I'll turn up my muzak a little bit too. Shoop. No noises. Yeah, weird. Get a better subwoofer. Thank you for the advice. Oh, sorry. I'll put my camera up here. I'll be better. Okay. Don't know why it's not making noises. Rip. Sorry, guys. So, if I miss anything, let me know. I'm gonna try opening Screen Labs in another tab and see if it works that way. Because that will, I will swear. I swear every time it happens. More like Scream Labs. That's right. It's Halloween. I'm really proud of the Necronomicon as like a Halloween name. Like, I don't know if you guys have really had the opportunity to notice, because I usually make you guys name everything. I'm terrible at coming up with names. It's like my secret shame. It's not even a secret. I'm very, very upfront about it. Copy. Paste. Oh, I can paste and go! That's a good name. I know, I was so proud of my pun. And I was like, I can't put it in yet because it's too long. And Twitter won't let me have that and my New York Comic Con table in my name. So. Like high five naming bad? I'm good at names like that. Like emote names and stuff, I think. Because that's like little concise things. But, like, when it comes to naming things... Oh, no, it still doesn't go! I forgot how to read! Thank you so much for that 4 months of support! How was the Iceland UK? It was amazing. Let's not talk about how bad I am at naming things and talk about Iceland and the UK. Because we had an amazing time. We got to spend a ton of time with our friend Craig, who, like, we see him, like, once a year. I can't believe I forgot to read again! But we get to see him, like, once a year, and it's always centered around a convention for, like, the past 4, 5, 6 years. And this year, we were like, we're coming for a week, and let's travel around the UK together. And he was like, I'm gonna take a bunch of time off, and we are gonna travel around together, and it was so fun. It was amazing. It's like how the people in Iceland have tricked you into eating Hagen rocks. Oh man, no, I was seeking out that candy. Genevieve got so mad at me. So yeah, like England, like the UK was amazing. Thought Bubble was amazing. I got to meet a couple of our regulars, which was awesome. Well, I mean, I met Captain Coffee Club last year, but I also got to meet So Very Bad at Stuff. It was actually really funny. So Very Bad at Stuff. I was just like looking around. Sometimes you're just at your table and you're like, whatever. And I looked and I made eye contact with someone and they started like, oh, hey, and like waving. And I kind of like looked around and was like, ah, oh, that definitely wasn't me. I've never seen that person before in my life. And I like went back to what I was doing. And then he came over and he was like, so I realized after I did that, that you had no way of knowing who I was. I felt like an idiot, and I was like, oh, it was to me. I'm confused. Yeah, so after the UK, we went to Iceland, which is gorgeous and amazing and beautiful, and so expensive to do anything, but it was amazing. We loved it. But Iceland is known- oh, see, I just did it. I just did the thing. I don't even know if you guys can see that, but I just, like, smudged the heck out of it. I'll erase it in a bit. It'll probably not be too bad. This is what I get for talking while I'm- I adore salty licorice. It is my absolute jam. I've loved it like my entire life. It's like a very Dutch thing, is like salted licorice. So I got a bunch. And Genevieve was like, I like licorice. I want to try it. So she was trying some of them. She's like, the first one. I was like, okay, start with this one. You'll like this one. And she ate it. She's like, oh, I do like it. And that was the school crate, the little school chalk. They look like little pieces of chalk. And they're like a minty, you know. I got them as like a palatable, I know what it is kind of thing. And I was like, okay, well, we tried this one. It's not so bad. And it was like a fish. And she tried it. And she was like, oh yeah, it's like a little salty, but that's quite nice. Good. And then we started on the hard candies that I got, which a couple of the candies I got from Iceland are the most, like, offensive is really the only word. It's like, it's an absolute assault on your taste buds. And they are the most offensive salted licorice candies I've ever gotten. And I love them. And Genevieve put one in her mouth. The moment, like, she tasted it, spit it back out, looked at me, and just went, why? And I laughed. It was so funny. But, like, the candy I like literally makes people gag. Their salty licorice is amazing. It's top notch. Two separate candies I bought were shaped like skulls, and one of them is like perfect. It's like a little wine gum salted on the outside. It's the like monosodium or whatever. Like it's a really like crazy salt thing. It's not actual salt. It's like saltier than salt. So that one is like perfect and amazing. And the other one is like a big thick candy with just this white salt on the outside. And it's also shaped like a skull, and it is no joke. That one, like, murders my mouth every time. I still eat it, but it, like, murders me. I need to try this licorice for research. I can bring you, like, a little sample pack, one of each. Or wait, are you coming to TwitchCon? I think so, right? I can't remember. But whenever I can... Not actual salt. Orochi! Hey, thank you so much. You're back. Oh, thank you. I'm back for 2 days. And then I'll be back for like... I'll be back... Monosodium... No, monosodium glutamate is MSG. That's like umami, that's not like salt. Which I was discussing with Jen that I literally have like MSG seasoning in my house. Cause it's foods deserve umami. You're doing it wrong. Oh, it's Selmiak is what it's like, what Dutch people call it. I don't know what the actual ingredient is. Because it's got like crazy, but Selmiak is the like, sodium chloride. Well, sodium chloride's normal salt though. February! I found out the other day that MSG has been bad for you the whole time I've been living a lie. Well, so when that whole MSG like, oh my God, don't eat MSG. When that whole craze was happening in what, the early 2000s? Maybe even earlier. And there was this big thing, like, oh man, studies shown MSG. And everyone was like, oh my God, it's so bad. But it was that same year that I finally looked at this seasoning that my family had been using my entire life on, like, rice dishes. And, like, I grew up way back, Dutch people kind of appropriated Indonesian food. So I've grown up eating Indonesian food. Kind of imitation, like Dutch imitation Indonesian food. But one of the seasonings we used on it, on like bami and nasi goreng, is Maggi, and it's just pure MSG. That's like, it's like the third ingredient. It's like water, salt, MSG. And I was like, oh, well, this stuff can't be that bad for you, because if it was, we'd all be dead. Like, my oma's been eating this her entire life. She's like, she was probably like 70 or 80 something at the time, but I mean, she's still kicking. These MSG on dishes as well. It is a flavor enhancer. I worked at a pho restaurant and they had three massive, like things in the back, and they were sugar, salt, and MSG. And like, it doesn't mean you should make a whole thing out of it. It doesn't mean that should be the only thing you put in a dish, but it really like brings the flavor out of a lot of things. And like, it's useful when it's used well. Like any ingredient. Pinky Bunny, how's it going? MSG makes food taste better. Exactly. I'm so glad I'm here for MSG talk. All I'm saying is I'm a fan. I have to be somewhere at like 6:45, 7. But that's kind of why I started the stream later, because then I was like, well, then I can just stream right up until I have to go, instead of like streaming for a few hours and then going like, oh, I could go longer, but I'm tired. Makes a fan. Do you have a grease airflow? Get out of here. Get out of here. I do this a lot. I'm really sorry. How is like the video too? From my angle, it looks okay. I was like, from my angle, it looks like you can't see anything. But I guess you can, or you wouldn't be here. I'm gonna name all the stuff that naturalizes MSG in it to people who talk about how it will kill you. Really? I didn't know like a ton of stuff had it naturally occurring. Beard. Well, that's why I have to ask, because you guys would like not even say, they'd be like, oh, you know what? It's her first time streaming in a while. I'm just happy Nick's back. And no one would tell me that like my heckin' like little cover was on my video or something. Like no one would tell me. You guys are the worst. Some people thought it was the culprit behind them having negative reactions to eating food from certain takeout places. Some people cited it as an allergen. You can't even be allergic to it without being allergic to things like meat, fish, cheese, and tomatoes. Yeah, there's definitely like a sensitivity to it. But again, I think it's more a sensitivity to like too much of anything, like too much meat or too much cheese. Like you shouldn't have too much of it. But it's made like my nose stuffy before. I would tell you. Thank you, Pinky. The lens cap on the camera for 4 hours, but you know what? She's happy to be here. So honestly though, I feel like you guys would do that. Eventually, I'll slap a little bit of white out on it. But not till the piece is done, because it'll get white. It'll get wet. It'll get dirty, is what I meant. You mean see Nick at MICC? Oh, yeah. With the fact that I'm sure not all food establishments have the best freshness practices. I imagine a lot of people are getting false positives. You know, there are certain places that eat the less than ideal stomach feels later. Oh no. Damn you, Taco Bell. There's like, I told this to Jen and she was like, under no circumstances are you taking me to whatever this restaurant is. But there's a restaurant in Toronto that I think just one time. But I wouldn't be surprised if it was more than once. But I think just one time. I got food poisoning from it. but I still go back there all the time. It was like one time out of 20 times I've been there. And I'm like, you know what? You're bound to have a day when you don't, you know, cook something all the way through. I just don't order the meat there anymore. But I still go and I still like take people to go because it's so good. Sober meat doesn't need Taco Bell. Drunk meat's a different story. Oh my god, where? It was Versed. But I love them, like, and, like, they follow me on, like, Twitter, and, like, I follow them back. Like, it's actually one of my favorite restaurants. It was just one time. And I've been there so often that, like, I've definitely eaten there over 20 or 30 or 40 times. Here come, let's eat the wheat. Oh, Lazy, hello! Cap change your emotes. Oh, that's right. Yeah, because they're like the Halloween emotes is such a cute idea. I love it. Haven't had a problem with them. I eat the vegan ones. Yeah, now I eat the vegan ones. But like I go with a ton of people and they still all get the meat ones and they've never had a problem. But the vegan ones there are honestly my favorite. The Mediterranean is like amazing. I love it. I get it every time I go. I still get their like dirty fries and stuff. So good. It's like a German beer hall microbrewery place in Toronto. It's so good. Yeah, Duke's got her Halloween emote out. Yes, and welcome, Cafe Vampire. I really like it. I love her little Halloween or her holiday emotes. Yeah, like I didn't even really want to say where it was because like I don't want to give them any negative press. I love it so much. Like still go. That's my recommendation. So cute. Yeah. So I'm going to have these at TwitchCon. Hopefully by like next year's TwitchCon, I'll have more of the Z-motes. But I really wanted to have just one done at least. So yeah, it's really big, but I think that'll be kind of fun. So you'll be able to see it like really well. Give it. I thought the same thing rocks. Corbin Armstrong, hey, how's it going? So yeah, I'll have this guy at TwitchCon. I hope you guys really like it. But eventually I will have an online store. And when I have an online store, all my pins and stuff will be going up. Even the mermaids, if they sell out, will be going up on my store because my friend who's running the store already has a supply of them. So I can get one before everyone else. You can. So yeah, I'm gonna have those at TwitchCon. So if you're gonna be at TwitchCon or like around TwitchCon, like we can always meet up in a coffee shop or something if you can't get in the doors, you know. That's not true. I have a light table. I could just trace it again. Yeah, I saw Dodger started the coffee company. I wanted to get some, but like, I don't know if they've fixed it yet. Well, A, I don't tell Dodger, but I haven't been drinking coffee recently. I was actually getting like anxiety attacks from caffeine. So I stopped drinking coffee. I drink mostly decaf now. I might drink like a little cup of coffee in the morning. But I really wanted to get a bag. But the shipping to Canada when it came out was like, whoa. It was like at least as much as the coffee itself. Which I'm not surprised because of duties and stuff, but I think they've solved it now. Get out of here! Dude, you guys are all the worst. Oh dear. Squidub, hey, how's it going? And yo, Davido, how's it going? We are a chat full of five-year-olds, apparently. Key, who did you get that poo emote from? Get out of here. Yeah, the international shipping has come down a tad. That's good. Oh. Okay. Hangouts was like, peace. It's back now. All by itself. I love the pink mermaid. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Candy. Good night, see your chance. I'll see you there. Gotta say hi to the super rare crew. Yeah. Oh, it's Michi Rap. Oh dear. And I'm not gonna do it on the like over top of my ink drawing. all the poop. Get out of here. Blip. There we go. I've got some of the Earl's garden keeping me warm today. Happy Inktober, thank you. So yeah, I'm not technically doing like Inktober. Inktober for me, every year I do it for about 4 days and then I fall off of it and I feel guilty and I don't do it ever again. So I thought the least I can do, which will be fun, is when I'm doing art streams, is to stream inks, which is cool. And yeah, I skipped day one of Inktober to tell myself, you know what, like, don't. You're doing an Inktober, not the Inktober. Yes. Happy second day of Halloween, of course. I'm Lurk for now. Good luck. Oh, for sure, Lazy. Thank you so much. Any anime since like June. Does that mean you haven't been watching My Hero? Oh my god. I'm so like, one day Dodger stopped by my stream and she was like, I'm gonna commission you and I'm gonna commission you a character from this anime, My Hero. Also, if you've watched it, like, let me know who your favorite character is. It's really, really good and I think you should watch it. And I was like, I'll give it a shot. You know, I haven't watched any anime in a while. Haiku's been on hiatus for And depending on the channel, it's also really hard to get things legally in Canada for some stupid reason. Charlie, thank you so much for that host. Oh my goodness. Thank you, thank you. Welcome if you're coming in from Charlie's stream. Were you doing an Inktober stream? I saw you were doing some like traditional drawings last night. You seen or heard of the HBO animated series, The Ricky Gervais Show? Oh man, I listened to all of the Podfathers podcast. It's such a good podcast, and Carl Pilkington is ace. I've never watched the animated, but like I've listened to everything it's based off of. Hope everyone's doing fantastic, of course. Thank you so much for that host, Charlie. How was your stream? Did the beginning and did some Animal Crossing. Amazing. Yeah, so for anyone coming in from Charlie's stream, welcome. And this is my first time doing a traditional art stream. I only have one good webcam, so excuse my potato face. And yeah, if you're wanting to hang out, that's awesome. And I hope you feel welcome to chat. I'm always here to answer questions. You're doing the traditional Inktober, or you have a different set? I'm just taking Inktober super easy. So I'm just kind of doing whatever feels fun. And that includes skipping days. That includes just like not necessarily having a theme, letting myself do fan art if I want to do fan art. So today I actually had a bunch of sketches that I really wanted to turn into ink drawings. So for today and tomorrow, I might just be doing that. So that I have some stuff to take to New York Comic Con. Skipping days? Yes, I skipped day one. And, Roni, welcome. Hello. I skipped day one specifically to take off the pressure. So yeah, if you're new here, I draw cute, cartoony pinups. I like them to be sexy, I like them not to be sexual. And I like them to feel like they have attitude and agency. And be body positive, of course. This is an old show, but has anyone watched Miraculous Ladybug? I haven't. I've heard such good things. As long as you have fun, exactly. Are you doing the like Animal Crossing Inktober? I didn't quite catch what you were drawing yesterday. It was just in a tiny thumbnail when I checked up on my Twitch app. Give Inktober a try, but only one drawing at my time it will be the last day of the month. Actually, WTile, there's also like Inktober, I'm not gonna talk about all the drama that happened earlier this year, when Jake posted the thing. But Inktober's always just been about trying to improve with a new tool. So one of the approaches to do Inktober is actually to like start one drawing and just draw it every day for like just make your way through it. If you want to work on something that's like more detailed than you usually do, or yeah, if you're just not fast or you just don't want the pressure of doing a different thing every day, you can work on one thing for multiple days, but it's just about like revisiting it and coming back to it. The drama, there definitely was some. I know. Ugh. Love your chubby pinups, make you feel good about my bod. Exactly, Squid Dub. No, I don't know. A, it's way more fun to draw when you've got like a million curves to work with. I don't know. I just love like the big lines and stuff. It's so fun. But I don't know. I really love when people come up to my table at cons and they're like, you made me feel really good about like buying my first bikini this summer. And it's like, that's awesome. Like, I couldn't wish to do anything else with my art. Like, that makes me really happy, and it makes me happy to know that like something I've done has made a bit of a difference. You can already see like I get really inky when I draw. What happened? People were asking, the short version is people were asking the official Inktober guy, Jake Parker, if they could do Inktober digitally. And his answer was, in short, no. You know, and like, no, that's not what Inktober is for. And I think you're missing out. The words that people took issue with were, you'd be missing out on the full experience of Inktober. But, like, honestly, like, Inktober is really the only thing that gets me away from working on my computer. And that's exactly what it was intended to do originally. You know, it's since become, like, a whole brand and, like, a huge thing. But I still remember Inktober being, like, just this thing that Jake tweeted about once a year. Like, it's still, in the end, his and meant as, like, a challenge. And, yeah. It has the word ink in the title. Well, like, digital inks are kind of the rebuttal. And I don't want to take away from anyone doing a daily draw, because daily draws are hard no matter what you do. Just getting the energy to draw every day is crazy. And if doing Inktober digitally is the thing that gets you drawing every day, that's amazing. But I do really think that the flavor of it is lost when you don't at least treat it like it's an ink drawing. Like, if it's about, you know, not having a super polished piece or not undoing all the time. And I've just seen a lot that, like, it's like, well, this is just a painting. Like, what about this says Inktober to me? Nothing. So, there isn't. This is not even real. It's true. It is. It's such a weird debate. And that's how I felt too. And I just, like, I didn't want to say anything about it on Twitter because everyone I know was like, let people do what they want. And I was like, I mean, yeah, but also I kind of agree with the person that people are saying is unreasonable. So I'm just not going to say anything. How do you not smudge with those pens? Hey, Kelly, how's it going? I smudge my hand with them. Like, ugh. How do you not ruin everything with watercolors? Also, hey, how's it going? I responded about karaoke, by the way. It's just, I think that's, like, no, it's the day before I do a workshop. It's not the day before, it's either the day before I do a workshop or the day before I leave for TwitchCon. It's one of the two. So I'm like, maybe I'll be really stressed. I don't know. So I'm just gonna have to, like, play it by ear for a bit. Because obviously I want to go. Is it a Pentel pocket brush pen? It is. I think it's the day before Canzine too. Oh my god. Are you guys gonna have the new Manfred at Canzine? I think he wants Nick to confirm. Nick, wait, what? I agree the dude who made the challenge can make his rules how he wants. Like, we all just choose how we participate. Yeah, that's true. No, it's, oh, okay. Because I want it when it comes out. I want it so bad. My what's it called? My bullet journal. That is sadly gathering dust more than I am drawing in it, or drawing in it, like writing in it. It's just covered in Manfred everywhere. Already answered about the pen? Okay, cool. Sorry for novels. That's okay, Defeb. Think about it. Is this a challenge? It's not a competition. Feel free to bend the rules and stick to your own regiment. Challenge yourself. Yes, exactly. Call it art. Yeah, that's what I think. Like, the argument I've been using is it would be like if I was sitting around in May, which wouldn't, and this would never happen, but if I was sitting there being like, I'm gonna draw centaurs all month and I'm gonna tag it mermaid. It's like, it's just a different thing. Like, don't just jump on the popular tag bandwagon if you're not doing it. I sound like such a bitch right now. I totally agree. I feel like Nick's right there. There's certainly a specific point to Inktober, and no one's putting you in prison if you bend the rules for yourself. Yeah, totally. I once I'm inking, the line stays even if it's wrong. Exactly. I'm doing it digitally, but I'm aiming more for drawing something every day. Minimal colors, no undo. See, and Josuga, that's kind of what I was talking about. Like, when people are doing Inktober like that, and I've seen a lot of people doing it using, like, the Kyle Webster, like, inking brushes, and oh, I'm gonna try out a different one of these inking brushes and a different method of digitally inking every day for the month. And I'm like, that's cool. That feels like it's in the flavor of Inktober. And yeah, trying to minimize undoing or erasing once you start inking. And like, yeah, that makes sense. Like that, you know. Exactly, do you like Drossenberg? Yeah. But no, I think if it's in the flavor of like still, I've just seen some really, really polished, like finished full like digital paintings. It's like, guys, no. Otherwise, why not just do a daily drawing? Exactly. And do like Drawtober or hashtag it whatever you want. Just don't jump on the one popular hashtag because it's popular. And I feel like that's what people are having a problem with is like, oh, but I want to do the popular one and I want to get my art out there. And it's like, then like I used to draw on sticky notes for Inktober with Sharpies. You know, it's not a cost issue. Nick's Ember. I can't believe Nick's going to prison. I am going to artist prison for skipping day one. It's true. That's actually, I keep saying I'm going to New York Comic Con. It's all a lie. It's all a ruse. I'm actually being sent to art prison. So, I mean, see you guys never. So that kind of sucks, but my markers always bleed with the lines. You need to find markers that work with your pens. So the Pentel, once it's dry, works pretty well with Copics. The Kuratake brushes though, not the one I have, not this one, but the Kuratake that are like the Pentel brush pen that have the free ink or the free flowing ink, those ones work amazingly with Pentels or with Copics. So you just have to find, Copics actually try to break down markers. So you have to find things that are specifically compatible with them. Copics and Prismacolors. Yeah, they're about the same formula, I think. Do you buy locally or order from JetPens? I haven't been ordering from JetPens yet. Right now, I just got most of mine from Desairs and like the Curries near OCAD had like the Pentel. And Desairs had this, which I was really surprised. It's a Kuratake curry color. It's very nice. Gypsy Sol and Octiza. Well, I really stumbled over that. Thank you so much for the follows and for joining the Nictor Horde. I really appreciate it. If you're enjoying the stream. How are you? I'm doing great. I'm back to streaming after a couple weeks of being away in the UK and Iceland on vacation, so like I'm super happy to be back and be here. You moved with that word? Yeah, okay. I tried. But yeah, I'm fantastic. I'm super happy to be back streaming for at least a little bit before I head off to New York. And then I'm not going anywhere till TwitchCon, so then we've got lots of time. I'll probably try and do some IRL streams from TwitchCon. 'Cause I buy SIM cards with really great data on them when I go down to the States, so I should just be able to go live. 'Cause there's no way I can use like 5 gigs in 2 days. Oh, Lucianne, thank you so much for that follow and for joining the Nictor Horde. I really appreciate it. Pickles, hey, so I've been getting in Terraria recently, and there's an achievement I think will make your day. It sounds so magical. Rainbows and unicorns. Fire a rainbow gun while riding a unicorn. That sounds like my cup of tea. When we were in Iceland, there was a rainbow every single day. It was magical. We were hashtag blessed. It was so cool. Seen any movies? I have not. Because I have just been gone. I just don't know. I don't know how they work. I like see like process images and stuff, and I'm like, I mean, I get it in theory. I get that like this shouldn't be as crazy as it is, but like I just can't do it. I used watercolors for a summer for life drawing, and that's the most comfortable I've ever been with them, and it still wasn't great. What are you drinking? I'm drinking the Earl's Garden. It's an Earl Grey tea from David's Tea. Like Carson drew it. I've sent you guys over to his stream a few times, but like he inks with like a full-on just big like bendy brush, and like I can't even control the Pentel brush pen. You just have to move everything all at once. Just move your whole arm. The only way I can keep lines stable. What music is this? I think it's still St. Vincent. Unless Spotify went its own way. It is St. Vincent. I just felt like I don't really listen to music, and I keep asking for recommendations, and every time I ask, at least three people are like, St. Vincent. So I was like, I'm gonna listen to St. Vincent today, and so far I'm enjoying it. They are painful for me to read. Caleb Chat's dragging me like this. Yo, but what ships? Oh, I can't even remember. I just remember being like, oh, it's so cute. I'm trying to like block it from my mind. Cause I don't want to ship. I'd say they're like the most obnoxious high schooler thing, but one of them I definitely updated through my first year of college. I like checked the date and I was like, are you kidding me? I was in college when I stopped writing this. So Bailey the Mouse, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nictor Horde. I'm so sorry that the alert sounds aren't working right now. But I see you and I welcome you. Oh no, Froppy is best. I love. Okay, wait. Is everyone caught up? I don't want to like drop spoilers. It's not really a spoiler. It's just like an offhanded comment. But I loved what they said about her in the matchup for the exam. It was just like, Froppy is best confirmed. Best girl confirmed. I guess that's okay. I wasn't really sure how I wanted that to go, and then it just happened. I don't know if I like it, but that's fine. It's fine. Wanna know what Bakugo's hero name? Did he ever end up coming up with a hero name that wasn't like Murder Machine? Doing random life updates. Remember how Polygon was hired for video producers? Yes, you submitted your app. Amazing. Like, good luck. I know you were saying, like, it'll never happen. But, like, you know what? It even only has a possibility of happening if you try. So I'm so happy that you, like, sent something in. That's awesome. Yes, Lord Explosion Murder Death. Lord Explosion Murder. Oh my god. I love him so much. I think, like, after the most recent episode, I think that the, like, main evil guy is my, like, trash son. I love him so much. Like, I adore him. Oh, dear. Like, I can't explain how much like, during this episode, I was just like, yes. Yes, you're perfect. Like, everyone, not everyone, but I feel like a lot of people at some point in their life, and this was definitely true for me, were kind of like I didn't go to an art high school, and coming out of high school I was like, you know, like cock of the walk, you know, I was like, yeah, I got this, I'm amazing, I'm like the best. And then I didn't get into the college I wanted to get into, and that had like never even occurred to me as a thing. And I feel like that feeling is so much encapsulated in Bakugo. Like, I feel like he's always been told he's amazing. He's never had anyone doubt his skills ever throughout his life. And now he's in a place where everyone is like just as good as or better than he is. And he's like, he doesn't know how to cope with it, and he's being such a teenager about it, and I think that's so relatable. And if you're curious, the little alerts that have been coming up when people follow and people host, that's also stuff I do. I'm normally an animator, but I decided for Inktober, it would be fun to do some traditional drawing streams. And of course I do my trademark little blushy cheeks and stuff on even my traditional drawings. Mineta is the problem with shonen anime that I have to accept because I love anime. Gonna slide in the lurk, no worries, lore, we'll see you later. Icy Hawk Guy, yes. He is like my son that I want to see succeed. Todoroki, I love him. But that little evil trash boy who just wants to watch the world burn. A side of being a teenager that you don't see it represented a lot. And I mean, when you're 16, you're like, yeah, I can do no wrong. I'm the best at everything. Like, that's... I've said it before and I'll say it again. Teenagers are awful. My apologies if you're a teenager. It's not that you're trying to be awful. It's that you'll look back on your teenage years and think about how much you've grown. I know I was awful as a teenager. That's where that comes from. But I feel like he's so relatable for something that no one talks about. And it's the feeling of like abject failure when you realize how stunningly mediocre you are. I'm living for this piece. Well, get ready to get rid of it, because it's time for something new in a minute. I'm gonna put little, like, lacies on her underwear. And it's time for something new. And you just squiggle around, and then that's like, you're like, yeah, that's lace. You just do some squigs, and you're like, there you go. Lace. And a half, thank you. Cool. So we go like this. We go, ooh, ah, ooh, such nice, very, very ink. Wow. Oh yeah, Bunny, you have to check on the little jigsaw on screen now. The little tiny... Where's my hand? Well, it's like this. Look at... Okay, well, I wiped it off a little bit. My hand's not as gross anymore. But my hands get so gross when I ink. Oh my god. Surprise it's not all over this. Okay, I'll try and erase that little bit again. See, like, who needs whiteout when you have these amazing... This one's a Sakura eraser. This one's from JetPens. this. Look at you. Buy this. It's so amazing. It's the, like, this kind of eraser is the heckin' best eraser that I've ever come across in my life. They're amazing. Look at how it erased the ink smudge that I did earlier. Why are your hands so big? Where are your, oh my God, my tiny hands. Oh my God, you're right. I've been a fool not streaming with my tiny hands in a hand-focused stream. I don't know if it's the same brand. Yeah, no, it's, this is a Sakura Micron brand one. This one's the Pentel brand one. But all the ones I found that look like this are the best. I thought they were going to be awful because it's a black eraser and sometimes the color from the eraser comes off on the page. But they're, wow, like they erase ink so well. They've been a godsend. On Jet Pens, then you probably have the Pentel Ein one because this is the one I got from Jet Pens. So I have gone on Jet Pens and I don't remember what I bought from there. Jet Pens is really reasonably priced. I think this one was like a dollar or something. It was cheap. I really like Jet Pens. Again, Jet Pens. If you want to sponsor me, I'll do more traditional streams, I promise. You run a very good service. So the reason I move my entire arm when I'm doing inks is because my hand is actually really, really shaky. And if I try and not have my hand resting, my lines will just wibble wobble all over the place. Oh, animated break, how's it going? Did you get a chance to play Cuphead yet? I saw you were gonna. Just got it, but I went to the doctor. I wanted to check out some sinus pain. Oh no, it's just allergies. Well, that's good. Good that you got it checked out though. I mean, we're in Canada. There's really no excuse to be like, I'm not gonna go to the doctor. Like, no, just go wait. What's the shipping like to Canada? Not bad. I can't remember exactly, but wine grab. Oh my goodness. I just saw that. Thank you so much for that resub for 4 months. Thank you for being one of our original nerds. That's so cool. You guys are all amazing. And thank you for all the resubs for my first stream back. That's always like really, really nice. God, I just want to play so much Cuphead. And all I want to do is like watch people play it. It's nice because it doesn't have a story, so it's like, well, I mean, it has a story, but it's mostly just a bullet hell. So it's like, oh, I can watch people play this and then still be excited to play it myself because it's not like I'm ruining anything. had to use cells, but I mean, heck, it worked out, so. Gonna get going, you're motivating me to doodle. Awesome, Squidab. Well, good luck doodling, and we'll see you around. That's so much harder in real life than it is on the computer. I've had some ink drawings in like the portfolio I take to conventions for a really long time. Like some of them are a year or two old from when I just started. I really only started using like the Pentel and inks like a year ago. Maybe like late 2015. A really steep learning curve, and seeing some of my like earlier work, I almost feel bad for trying to pawn it off on people. It's like, it's really shaky. But I mean, that's just how it is when you're learning. Love your hair, thank you. Thank you, thank you. It's appearing to be much more purple than it is on this webcam. It's a fairly like white purple. I think I might go kind of an intense purple for TwitchCon though. Think that'd be fun to like show up with just bright purple hair. A little heart tattoo. Yeah! My business partner, Genevieve, and I both have the same heart tattoo. We have a few matching tattoos, but that one was the first one that matched. And was like my second tattoo. Like we went to get tattoos together and I got three at once. And that was one of them. Dream Girls and Tummies is my favorite thing. It's a little sad that it didn't really get translated into the anime, but in My Hero, I know I've been talking about this anime so much, but it's so good. In the manga, the artist actually like took a lot of care to draw the girls with a lot of different body types. So it hasn't talked about it too much in the show, but like that one girl who like makes things out of like can produce things off of her body, she's actually making them out of adipose cells, with like fat cells, So in the manga, canonically, like, the reason why she has such a big chest, like, she's also got, like, really wide hips and, like, a bit of a belly, and because it's, like, she has to be able to use her power. And that's the reason why, like, in the second episode or third episode or wherever, Uraraka's like, oh my goodness, like, I'm so embarrassed. I didn't think this was going to be skin tight, because she's actually supposed to be, like, by, again, like, by Japanese standards. So, like, it's not huge, but, like, she's supposed to be a bit of a bigger girl. And she's, like, feeling really self-conscious about how her costume turned out. Like, it's so sweet and so, again, like, just teen. Now I have to watch this show. Yeah, so in the show, unfortunately, because of the production schedule, the designs that hit the floor are very, like, typical anime girl body type, which is, like, very small, very skinny. But the artist has, like, gone on record being like, I wish it wasn't like this, but now that we're into the production schedule, like, we don't want to change the designs partway through. But, like, if you look at the manga drawings, they are, like, really sweet. Watching Little Witch and various K-dramas. Nice. Oh yeah, Suya best girl though. Yes, a little froppy. Just the anime with the Invisible Girl! Yes, the Invisible Girl is like, oh my god, they gave her so much character just as like a background character. She's like one of my favorites. And she's like always so like blushy and cute. Oh my god, I love her. And she's literally invisible. You only ever see like her hands. It's so good. She's so perfect. And at the beginning, she makes, like, this comment, like, oh, I always fade into the background. And if you look, like, back on every shot, she's in pretty much every shot. And you're like, oh, no. Am I taking Emiote commissions? Hell no. No, like, I'm not gonna be around for the next couple weeks, so I feel bad taking any kind of commission that's not, like, the sketch commissions that I've been. Scene. I have some special prices up for like really sketchy like commissions on my iPad because I can do them on the plane and that. Kojima just said she likes girls like Yoko Taro did with 2B, then I'd be fine with Quiet. Honestly, if Hideo Kojima had been like, I like to have like is something to look at in a game. You know, if he'd been straight up just like, I wanted to make a sexy chick, I'd have more respect than what he ended up saying. Mostly because there has been a male character with her exact scenario, and that male character was fully clothed in full army fatigues. Like, there, so he's already established in his own universe that that's not even a good reason. Rocking out a nice hairstyle, thank you. Always living out the fashionista style. I mean, ugh. Also, I know she's not here, but you guys should thank Jen for me having my webcam on, because I was almost like, I'm just gonna pull a Carson and just draw. And she was like, people miss your face. Put your face on. And I was like, fine. And Jero Shinu, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nictor Horde. I really appreciate it. I hope you're enjoying the stream. I definitely put that up too high. There's nothing on it. It's fine. Again, my... like... it's a miracle that my drawings aren't covered in finger smudges. Always. And I don't know if where you read it would have, like, if it was like a fan wiki or something, it probably has a link to, like, the other character who's known to have the same... is it a disease? I don't know. The same, like, makeup. It's so stupid. Even run somewhere in a bikini. Like, bikinis are not friendly for moving around in. And all it takes is practice. I feel like my lines are one of the only things I've got going for me. I'll see you later. I'll see you later. Thanks so much for coming by, and hopefully I will see you soon. Guys, if you've never seen her work, you should go, like, check out Twitter or something, at least. If you're not streaming. Because Moose Kleenex is an absolutely amazing artist. Although I have been thinking about expanding back into dark red again, because I do like dark red. I'm wearing a purple hoodie right now. There's a black hoodie, yes. And I really like the, like, heather gray one too. I would get either of those. What's that little Z doing on screen? Oh, the little Z when it's on screen, that's a little treasure chest that you can hit for bonus kittens. So when you see that little Z, you gotta go BAM! And hit it before it goes away. Oh, Dreamsicle Spit, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nectar Horde. I really appreciate it, and I hope you're enjoying the stream. You ever got your logo as a throw pillow? Oh my goodness. A little like Z. Oh. Oh no, I love it. Oh no, Richard, I love it. What have you done? Now I'm gonna have to figure out how to make that happen. I have one that's like two together, and I don't think I'm up for doing that one yet. When you're like, I probably shouldn't have just written that on the actual drawing. Probably should have like written that and then put it on the drawing. But not safe. No, they're not nips, they're pasties. Thank you very much. They're gonna be colored in black. There's gonna be no way to mistake them for nips. Twitch, please don't ban me. They're not nips. They're pasties. And since she's a little devil girl, I was thinking of doing her entirely in red. And then adding some lines. Enhance, get out of here, you grosso. Lesters have nip nips. But yeah, I'll be right back. I'm just gonna go to the washroom. So yeah, see you. Also, I think, Pinky, I think you asked to see, like, the one with the two. So that's the other one. I want to do it, but I want to, like, warm up a bit more, because if I start getting really thick lines in here, it's really going to mess everything up. So you don't want to die. Yeah, I really, really like that one. VRV screen is a sticky note? I mean, I'm working on it. I've never done like a traditional stream before. These are not, they're not nipples, Twitch. They're pasties, okay? And I know they're the same shape, but I promise that they're not. So please don't ban me. So yeah, I thought it might be cool to like color block her whole body in the red, and then just pick up on the details in the black. So Ducky, hey, how's it going? Oh my goodness, if body paint streams can happen with just pasties, I think you should be fine. Yes, exactly. Also, like, it's not like I'm having her, like, you know, I was just like, you know, but you know, it's very innocent? It's not innocent. It's tasteful. I guess her lips will be black then. I do the black first, it's likely to smudge, since I'm doing so much red. So I want to make sure that I'm like... But then I have to kind of leave something here to remind myself, because I'll lose my entire sketch under this red, since my sketch is in red. Like, I understand that they just don't want to cross a line between, like, end up becoming, like, a cam girl site. I get it. But I have seen much more sexual work without, like, that still meets all of Twitch's guidelines, doesn't show any bits. But, like, I find it, like, I honestly feel like my stream is very family-friendly, despite the odd heck word, despite the odd, you know. She eats Odin's food, and she's gonna get fat. And that's not good. She's already gained 10 grams since last year. I think 20 grams since last year, and the vet was like, you don't let her do that. So. Rank 1 Africa, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nicktur Horde. I really appreciate it, and I hope you're enjoying the stream. Fat kitty, no! She's such a healthy girl. She's a very small cat. introduced him to the tiny hands, and immediately he was like, yes, these are my favorite thing. And then proceeded to just do amazing things with them. We were so impressed. As much as I would like a butt ton of tiny hands. I have an art project that we have to research an artist, and I wanted to interview you, Nick. We have to find an artist on some website. Oh, I don't know what the website is, but actually maybe I'll use my brush side. Also, do you like how gross this marker is? I refilled it exactly one time and just it overflowed everywhere. Ducky or someone on stream. But when it's just someone contacting being like, it's a school project and I have to interview you. I mean, I'm glad that they do have a website database because it's probably to stop you from cold calling artists who like... I don't know, be like a nerd and a loser your whole life and then find a group of people and like realize that you all have the same interests and you're all nerds. And then your life is just people. True, true. And of course, if I was able to interview you, I would make sure you were okay with it. Of course, for sure. And I would always be honest. I would never be like, sure, I can do it, and then, you know, bail out or not, you know. Probably trim it down with some white. I don't like how thick it is. They teach you 3DX Max or Maya. They taught us a little bit of Maya. The Maya program's way better now than it was when I went. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Charlie, too. You guys are too sweet. Guys, these things are also total lifesaver. Uniball. White gel pens, they're just the best. I knew it would look goofy while I was just doing the red bits. That's also kind of the fun part of doing the color blocking. Have to wait till I have some money, but I really, really need to commission them. Like, I need a Kevin Wada commission in my life. I need a Jim Mafood commission in my life. And Jen Bartel and Babs and all of my lovely lady friends who are just so heckin' good at art. For dropping by. It's always lovely to see you around. Oh no! Ah. This is bothering me. It was just like the tiniest bit of white that probably wasn't even showing up on camera. And I was just like, I can't deal with this anymore. Yes, Babs is doing all MHA stuff for Inktober. I don't know how long she's been watching it, because I felt like I just started hearing her talk about it, and then she went to like a My Hero specific convention in Boston, and I was like, excuse you, that's amazing. but also it's amazing and I love it. I only very recently got into, like, Image comics and stuff, and it's just been because of Twitch app unfollow me, but so Inexpensive Gamer, I feel like that's like an issue that's just been happening on Twitch. I tuned in to like multiple streams yesterday and had to refollow almost everyone, which is really dumb. So thank you for the refollow, but I feel like Twitch is having a weird glitch where it's unfollowing people. So everyone, check your follows. Glitter. We have glitter? Well, not like, now I'm getting your hopes up, not like real glitter. Although I guess I could go out and get real glitter. Are amazing. They're the best. Oh, I smudged everything. It's fine. It'll be fine. I'll erase. prompt list isn't to like rein you in or anything. The real reason is some days you might get stuck. And when you're stuck, it's really, really useful to be able to fall back and go, well, I'll just do this because this is what the prompt list says to do. But I feel like sticking to it hard and fast. If there's something you want to do more than what's on your prompt list, then like that's definitely what you should be doing. Small Tom Gaming, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nictor Horde. I really appreciate it. And I hope I was literally about to be like, not this song. I don't like this song anymore. And then it ended, so. That's why I love filling things in all one color, because you can kind of heck up a bunch and then be like, who cares? It's all one color anyway. Do you often use traditional art mediums? This is definitely the first time I've streamed traditional art. I am usually a digital artist. I pretty much only do traditional art at conventions. For people. So I wouldn't say I'm really well versed in it. I was saying earlier that I've only been really using inks and stuff for the past year. Outside of just sketching, I've never really been one to do a lot of traditional stuff. A little discordant sounds for me. I'll try the next song. Super relaxing to watch people work in traditional IMO. How are you enjoying streaming it so far? I'm enjoying it a lot, actually. I didn't know how well my setup would, like, transfer over, but I literally just, like, kind of tilted my webcam down and I'm using my built-in webcam on my computer for my face cam. And I think it's working fairly well. when I play games, some of the people who, like, have followed me since the very, very beginning show up. Because I started off But yeah, Punzilla is very rad. She also does amazing work. Here, we've got a couple requests lined up. I'm gonna put on our music player. Hey, Gamer Girl, thank you so much for that auto host. I really appreciate it. Let's put it all the way up. Must head out, but great stream. Oh, thank you so much, Peppermint Swirl, and thanks for stopping by. It's always great to have some new faces in chat. I really appreciate it. I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. I don't think I like the one on her boob. So now it is gone. Skullbash Hero, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nyctur Horde. I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoy the stream. And while these things are on, guys, remember if you click that little like jigsaw piece somewhere around where all this like all the stuff down in the bottom corner is, you can like request songs and stuff with kittens. Or I don't think you need kittens anymore. You can just request songs. So if you want to get a song in the queue, go for it. Shiny boob. Not anymore. No more shiny boob. Oh, I'm between putting the glitter and lines in there and just leaving it, because I kind of like it. It's so simple. Come on. Like, look at what a nice white line that is. Like, I wouldn't be able to function without this white pen. Can I please buy a Zeonic pen with my 34,000 kittens? I don't think so. But I will definitely, after TwitchCon, do a giveaway for them. So the Uniball never gives me the taper I want. So then I go in and re-taper the line. John Graham! Hey, how's it going, man? You guys don't follow John Graham. He's an amazing creative streamer. You should totally check him out. How's it going, dude? Me's okay. Just eight, feeling great. Awesome. I'm fantastic. This is my first time streaming in like a while. I just came back from like a huge vacation. Went to the UK and Iceland. And I'm heading out for New York Comic Con in a little bit this week. So like, I'm having a great time. Happy to be back. Happy to be back and trying out some creative, or some traditional creative stuff for once. Oh, don't do that. You watch me get increasingly salty in the VOD. Oh, Pinky, for some reason it didn't click that you'd played it on stream. That's super cool. Dino Ender, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nyctar Horde. I really appreciate it, and I hope you're enjoying the stream. Game looks too dope. I haven't played it. I can't. I only have a Mac right now and a PS4, so I don't have anything. Like, I think it's not on either of those, right? I kind of like everything sitting together here, like not having lines all over her chest. She says while putting more lines all over her chest. You know what I mean. No white lines. Like, I'm kind of really digging this right now. I think she looks pretty fun. I'm pretty happy with that. Feeling good. Just Xbox and Windows, yeah. I'm gonna get a PC sometime soonish, I hope. So, hopefully when I get my PC, it'll be fine. Good. I love it. I'm really happy I went the route of like blocking it all in red. I think that was like a really fun choice. Pile of sketchy goodies. Oh, this one! I like this one. Don't take her off the screen, I love her! No! Oh, thank you, John Graham! Yeah, so I had a bunch of things pre-sketched, because for some reason I feel really self-conscious about doing traditional art sketches on stream. I also was like, I'd sketched them digitally previously and kind of traced them on my Lightbox, so there wouldn't have been a lot to watch. But chair request songs, please. Yeah, this is the last one. If there's no more song requests, I'll move back to Spotify. So don't know songs there? Yeah, but there's like a little search function. So you can search through what songs there are available. At least, like, you don't need to know offhand. Her hair is super poof. Just get it all over your hands. Good job, girl. Gambling's been more hardcore. I gained 4k and lost 3.7. Gotta go. Thanks for the chill stream. Well, thanks so much for coming by, Rainbow Sparkles. I really, really appreciate it. I hope you had a lovely time. I hope you have a lovely day. We'll see you around next time. I also have to duck out. Oh, no worries, Blind Observer. Thanks so much for coming by. Guys, it's... like, it really means a lot that I've kind of been away for a while and all you guys are right here the moment I get back. It's very nice. I really, really appreciate it. And I know I'm gonna be kind of on and off for a little bit still, but we'll be back to normal soon enough. And I mean, who does anything in winter, right? If I don't use Stream Element, I don't get kitties. It's Streamlabs now, and I think it should be fine. It's all built in to Twitch now. So as long as you click that little jigsaw puzzle piece on your screen, it should work. And Miley's Twerk Team, nice to see you. How's it going? Oh, that line got really, really, really thick. Let's just make all the lines around here thick. It'll be fine. The future is now. Yes. Oh. might have a slight gambling problem. Keeps playing scratchers. Oh no. Well, I have you. You need to put more Z-motes on Discord. No, I... Oh, wait. Which ones are they that aren't on Discord? Because that's what it is, right? There's some that are on FFZ that aren't on Discord yet. So I made it onto Artist Alley. We'd love to stop by your booth. Oh, at New York? That'd be awesome. Yeah, this will be my third year at New York, I think. It's like one of my favorite shows. Scratchers room me in another channel. Refuse to play those. Oh, TwitchCon! Yeah, yeah, yeah! Sorry, my mind can only take... can only keep track of one at a time. Yes, I will also be at TwitchCon in the Artist Alley. With friend of the stream, Metagame Mike. Really, those are all missing. I'm gonna take a little screenshot of those. Forgive my camera sound. But that way I have like a little reference when I think about it to put those on Discord. It might not be soon. But go grab a sandwich real quick. Awesome. Best of luck in your mission for sustenance. I went to the gym for the first time in like a month or two today. Partly from just being lazy and partly from the trip. But afterwards when I was eating, like I had like my smoothie, and then I had the soup I was gonna have for lunch. And then I had to like make some potatoes. Like, I was just so hungry. Cause I haven't... Like, I've been walking, you know, 10K a day, but I haven't ran or lifted weights or done anything demanding. You got wrecked with card stuff. I don't know how I feel. Yeah. The gambling... I don't know. Originally, I was like, oh man, the gambling's way easier and everyone looks like they're winning. And now it's like, no, no. The gambling is serious business. How are you getting on with the arts? Also, yes. I want to see everything, especially after leg day. Yeah. And the arts are going well. This is our fourth piece this stream, so feeling pretty good with how the stream's going. This song. What? I love it. Oh my god, what is this song?
Boulevard of broken dreams, where the city sleeps, and I'm the only one, and I walk alone.
Who did this? Like, this isn't like a Neil C remix, is this? I wouldn't be surprised. Purple Fury. Oh, okay. Very interesting. Oh, Fusspot, thank you so much for that host. How's it going? I'm sorry I missed that. Do you like my- I love this. Like, me comparing it to, like, a Neil Cerciega track is a high compliment. The Little Oddling, thank you so much for the follow and for joining the Nectar Horde. I really appreciate it, and I hope you're enjoying the stream. But his new music remixes are phenomenal. And of course, like, Brody Quest, oh my god, one of my favorite things on the internet. Like, thank you, Neil Cerciega. Close enough. Circles. Why do I want to draw them? Brody Quest is love. Brody Quest is life. Brody Quest is, perfection. Like, the song itself I could just listen to for hours, and then bonus, the video is so funny. Can I send you the best version, but on YouTube? Yeah, you can either post it in the Discord or, like, whisper it to me. I'm not 100% certain how open my whispers are, though. Oh boy, when your lady streamer whispers can get pretty weird. So I might have locked him up tight. I don't know. Is Brody Quest on SoundCloud? There's only one way to find out. I feel like most of Neil Cerciega's stuff's on SoundCloud. So guys, we've talked a lot about my absolute unironic and very pure love of Linkin Park. And this song that's on right now reminded me that how I found Linkin Park and how I like learned I loved them was through a MIDI version of Crawling that was on someone's live journal. These are all true. This is a true story. And I've just realized what song this is as well. So good pick, good pick. Linkin Park, I know. I wish I could cancel my request and add Brody Quest. I can cancel your request for you. Oh, never, don't worry. Don't worry, Pinky. Moran's got you. RHD162248. Thank you so much for that follow and for joining the Nyctar Horde. I really appreciate it, and I hope you're enjoying the stream. MIDI, Tears of Nostalgia, yes. But it was like a MIDI track with the lyrics next to it. So like, I thought it was like way more melodical than it was. And then I heard the actual version and I was like, no, I still love this. Lurking and you're not sure if you want to lurk anymore, then come say hi. And if you're lurking and you're like, no, I'm sure I want to lurk forever, then keep lurking. That's cool too. But know you're OSU Mario Kartman. I usually say fart as my resub notification, but I would never say fart to a lady. Thank you so much for that resub, man. That's awesome. 4 months, man. Like, all these OG subs coming through, and that's amazing. Thanks so much, dude. How's it going? I've been but lurking in High Five chat recently. I haven't actually been talking in the stream. I also watch on my PS4 app, so it's like really hard to chat unless I have the chat open on my phone. Stupid. Just finishing up work, how are you today? Great, this is the first time I've ever done like a traditional art stream and I feel like it's going really well. I'm liking it, sounds like y'all are liking it, so that's great. Still making awesome art, I see. Jay-Z Cannibal, yes, thank you. I try my best, haven't been here for a long time. Well, hey, thanks for coming by, I appreciate it. I'm probably gonna wrap up in a little bit after this one's done, but always appreciate people stopping by. Stop by while I rim my bats. I won't be here long anyway. You're doing Inktober for the first time? That's awesome. I was kind of saying earlier, I'm doing a much looser approach to Inktober this year than I normally do. Which is to say, not bothering with a theme, not bothering with a schedule, and just kind of embracing that it's a nice time to get into doing some traditional artwork. Scoobs, thank you so much for that follow and for joining the Nyctar Horde. I really appreciate it and hope you're enjoying the stream. Play Persona 5 yet? I have not. My friend, who is lending it to me has still not lent it to me. But soon, I'm sure she will. I'm sure she'll remember. I've also been away. Like, this entire time I haven't been streaming, I haven't just been, like, lazing around. I've been lazing around just in Iceland and the UK, not anywhere near anything I could be using to playing games. To play games, wow. Oh, your hair's so good. Love your haircut. Thank you so much, Collins and Cuske. You drew witches so far? Amazing. I had a list last year that was 100% witch prompts. And I had a lot of fun for those 4 days that I did Inktober. I really want to do down here, but I'm certain it's not dry yet. I'm like, no, don't do it. Give me my little sticky note of making sure my markers are clean. Song in the background's from Persona 5. Ooh, awesome. Oh no, I can't wait to play Persona 5. I know I'm gonna love it. It's like weird visual novel and also full video game. Like, everything about that is something I'm into. Maybe her little lollipop can be r oh, but if it's red, then it kind of feels like it should have been not outlined. Maybe I'll make it pink. No, maybe I'll just leave it. Oh. Doing Inktober instead of planning NaNoWriMo? Oh man, I've never. I think maybe my first one of my first fan fictions started as like a NaNoWriMo thing, but then I just did not continue with it ever. I've never properly done it before. Awesome. So I think she's all done. So we did four lovely lady drawings today. I'm very happy. I get closer to finishing each year. I have one friend that I've known since high school. We're like kind of acquaintances now. But every single year, she has like successfully done NaNoWriMo since I've known her. And I'm like, wow. Like, that's crazy. Oh, yeah. Let's get some Brody Quest going. What a bop. Look at all these. Look at all these ladies we drew. Wow. Wow, they can't even all fit on screen at the same time. Wow. It's like she's being Grease. I really like the way the devil lady turned out. I was so productive. I am really loving this idea, especially going into like New York Comic Con. This is giving me stuff to actually like bring there to have. It's amazing. I'm wondering if I should color her, like, little bikini in red and, like, the sarong in. With the nun-colored hair? Oh, this one? Yeah. I like it, because then I don't have to resolve whatever the heck's going on up here, you know? It's just blank. Like, who cares? It looks nice. But if I have to put lines there, I don't know what's going on. Sometimes you just have to lie and be like, it's done. It's over. I should probably make a cute tattoo. Oh, that'd be awesome. I'd love to start getting into doing, like, tattoo stuff. Kind of, sort of, maybe. Oh. Well, amazing. I still have, like, 3 more that we can do tomorrow, which is awesome. And on this lovely, lovely song, I may look for someone to raid. Oh my god, I can't believe Dukes is playing Cuphead again. This is like her 3rd stream in a row. It's awesome. Be cute with the red bikini. Yeah, I think I might do it. Made it back in time to raid. Oh yeah. So I'm gonna bring my keyboard back over so it's a little easier for me. Oh. Odin's being a little sleepy sheepy. She's trying to finish Cuphead today? Oh man, awesome. Time for my bath. We'll try and come by more often. Well, thanks so much for coming by today. I super, super appreciate it, Jay-Z Cannibal. So, thanks for coming. Hope you enjoyed it. And I hope we'll see you around soon. Cuphead was made in Toronto. I know there was a bunch of the team that was in Toronto for sure. All right. Where should we go? You know what? Juicy Doodles, oh my goodness. Hello, but we are just about to go raid, so I hope you'll join us in our raid call. Let's go host friend of the stream, Carson Druitt. If you guys are unfamiliar with Carson's work, he is an absolutely amazing ink illustrator and, like, painter. I see a Z. Do you? Oh yeah, there she is. Oh, she's like, yeah, she's right here. She's right here, a baby girl. But yeah, Carson's absolutely amazing. He's been super supportive of me as a streamer, both on Twitch and in real life. So if you guys could, like, head over there and give him tons of love with the Nick raid, that'd be awesome. You can put any emotes you want on the side. My raid call's super boring, but, like, have fun with the emotes and stuff. If you have our channel emotes, please use them. Our FFZ emotes won't work in the raid, so, you know. And yeah, just wait for the host to come up on screen. And once the host comes up, and Carson says hi, then, like, raid away. Make our presence known, don't be super obnoxious. But yeah, everyone post at least once, maybe twice, maybe 3 times, and then we'll leave it at that, and you guys can all hang out and enjoy Carson's awesome Inktober project that he's doing with the lovely Lady May. So I think the Lady May, I'm unclear, but I think she, like, wrote the themes and then he's, like, doing all the art. Or maybe they're both doing the theme. I'm not sure, because Lady May is also an amazing creative streamer. But I'm getting off the path to raid here. So, bam, there it is again. Everyone, click that link, head right over to Carson's stream, and I will be there in just a second. And yeah, I hope you all had a lovely time today. Thank you all so much for coming to my first stream back. We'll be doing the same thing tomorrow, probably 2 till 5. So keep that in mind. We were streaming a little late today. So yeah, I hope to see you at 2 tomorrow, and we'll do some more Inktober stuff. And yeah, it's so lovely to see you all again. Thank you all so much for coming. And I will see you tomorrow. Goodbye.